So I'm here with Eric Lane, the interim head coach for Lower Columbia. And Eric, right at the bat, you know, you've been an assistant coach for the last couple of years. Have you had to change any of your mindset now that you're the head coach?
Oh, definitely. I know there's just little responsibilities you got to learn. But, you know, it's still the competing, still baseball. You know, everything's the same as far as the rules go. So just getting those guys prepared a little differently. But, you know, it's been a smooth, you know, transition, especially with some really good sophomores coming back. But, you know, it's obviously little things here and there that I've got to take upon myself. But it's been good so far. So.
You know, we talk about, you know, the sophomores. You've got a few guys coming back, but this team's pretty young. A lot of freshmen coming in. So what are some things you've tried to focus on to help those guys transition from high school to college ball?
You know, just how hard you have to go, how long you're at the field, you know, having school work to, you know, do during the day and then come out and have a long practice, and just how, you know, how hard it is to play at this level. You know, try to get that to them, and obviously how hard you have to work to be really good at it. So trying to get that and, see, you know, get those guys and bust them around a little bit. So,
and you actually played here at Lower Columbia. And so what's it like to, you know, kind of do that full circle where you're coming here as a player and now you're here not only as an assistant coach but now as a head coach?
Yeah, it's actually been, you know, some luck obviously in there. You know, when I decided to get into coaching and just spent 1 year at Gonzaga, and then, you know, the former head coach Eddie Smith, he came here right that year, and so he needed an extra hand, and, you know, I happened to be available. So I got here for that, for his assistant coach, and then, you know, with Eddie leaving this year, it gave me an opportunity to be the head guy, and it's been exciting. You know, it's awesome to be around this program and this community. So it's been a great ride so far, and, you know, hopefully there's gonna be good days to come.
You know, and Eddie, you know, he won two championships, you know, here with the team. What are some things you've taken from his coaching style and kind of used this year, you know, for your own sake?
You know, just, you know, really taking care of the details, making sure everyone has a job and that they're doing their job. I mean, you know, Eddie's a really, really good competitor, and, you know, you try to mimic that as best as you can. Obviously, there's going to be some things we do a little bit differently. But it's, you know, it's been just those detail-oriented things and coming out and competing every single day and being organized and having a practice plan, having a game plan, and just being the preparation part of it's been huge. So, you know, learning from him for that. So,
and then for you, you know, once again as a player, you know, what motivated you coming up through, you know, low league, high school, into college? What kept you going, and really, who was kind of your inspiration to push you to be your best?
You know, it's just probably my family, you know, the inspiration. You know, my older brother played at University of Washington, played a little bit of minor league baseball. You know, my middle brother played a lot of baseball as well, just running around the yard with them. That's where it first started, and I think with all these guys, it's the same. You know, that's where you first learn how to compete, you know, this game. And, you know, that's been a big inspiration. I've had really, really good coaches that demanded a lot. And I think you really have to have a good foundation, a passion for the game to motivate you every single day. And if you're not passionate, it's really hard, especially at this level, to bring it every single day and get better. So I think that passion mixed with, you know, the experience with really good coaches and my family, big time.
So this year, obviously the goal is always to win the championship, but what are some lower goals, some things you want to focus on with the team and want to see them achieve as you go through the season?
Just being focused and disciplined, you know, every inning. You know, you have the goal to win the NWAC championship every year, and, you know, that's the expectation, but you have to take care of, you know, each game and, you know, each practice every single day. And so it's really just, you know, staying in the present, really attacking, you know, the practice plan each day. You know, and the small goal is just, you know, we're really focused on, you know, winning the next fall game, but, you know, winning each game one by one and staying the first inning through the ninth inning and make sure we stay focused and disciplined. So,
awesome. Well, thank you very much, Eric.
Yeah, thank you.